Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in for this video. We are going to continue our discussion of the concepts and the material that we are covering for the product design and development course. This is our reference, which is the product design and development by Carl Orrich, and we are using the 7th edition. Today we are going to start our discussion and start a series of videos about the product architecture, which is chapter 10 in this reference. We are still in the product development process, and product architecture is one of the steps in this process, and it's a method. So how did architecture, and what is the method that we're going to be using to identify and develop the architecture of our product? So I know that each one of you has their own project, and we now need to create an architecture for our project. So just to recall what we've done so far, so we've worked with planning, and that in planning we made decisions about the platform that we're going to be using to move forward, what kind of platform we are going to adopt in order to create our product. So each product can have different platforms. Something can be technology driven, other can be market driven. So you select our complex platform, you just build on top based on the characteristics of your product, what kind of platform you want to use. And that was the planning stage. Then we move to the concept development stage, and we were doing concept decisions. So we have created a lot of concepts. And we have selected a couple of these concepts, and then we asked for feedback from end users in something called concept testing. And we should be now at this moment ready with a concept that we would like to move forward in developing. After deciding our concept, the one that we want to work with and we want to develop, then it comes something called system level design. And this is a decomposition decision. So you can see that we are making decisions. We are here at this stage where we're going to now start looking at the system level design and the components of our product. So we have an idea, we have a general concept about what our idea will do and how the product will function. Now we need to go into the details of it. And this is what we call the product architecture. I want to keep just in mind, we did platform decision, concept decision, and now we have to do decomposition decision and identify what kind of components our product should have. Now, product architecture is determined early in the development process. So we need to, after deciding what concept we want to move forward with, then we have to do the product architecture before going to the detailed design and the testing and refinement. So what is a product architecture? So the definition is that the product architecture is the assignment of the functional element of the product to the physical building blocks. So if you remember, we did something called functional decomposition, that if you use a product, you need, what are the steps that you're going to follow to in using this product. Now we need to put the functional elements, and we want to create physical building blocks that describe the functional element. Also, our task is to define the basic physical building blocks of the product, so we need to identify them now. What do I need in order to achieve that function? What they do, and what their interfaces are with other building blocks inside my product. So we need to identify what are the building blocks and how do they interact with other building blocks that makes our product. And we will present, as usual and as always, we're going to present a method, a structured method to establishing the product architecture that we will care about. We are going to use an example in our videos. And the example will be the Hewlett-Packard disk jet printer. And we're going to refer to this as we move on in our discussion about the product architecture. Now, keep in mind, product can be thought of in both functional and physical terms. And we'd like to talk a little bit about this. So what are the functional elements and what are the physical elements? So functional elements of a product are the individual operations and transformations that contribute to the overall performance of the product. For example, for this printer, some of the functional elements are, well, first, store a paper. That's a functional element. Another functional element is communicate with the host computer. That's a functional element. And they are usually described in schematic forms. And if you remember, before identifying the technology or the components of those elements, functional elements. Keep in mind, if you remember our functional decomposition that we did earlier of the grill example. So this is what we mean by functional elements. After you identify your functional element and after you describe the functionality of your product, then you do something called physical elements, identifying the physical elements. And the physical elements of a product are the parts, the components, and the sub-assemblies that ultimately implement the functionality that we have described earlier. Physical elements become more defined as the development process develop. As we move forward, we are going from schematic and description and functionality into elements and components and physical components. We're going to discuss in the following videos other concepts related to the product architecture. So please stay tuned. Thank you for watching and until next time.